Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to show you a holster I got for my Smith & Wesson Model 327 Pug Nose. Now, this is a leather outside the waistband holster made by a company called Lobo Gun Leather. Now, I think it's only one person that makes these custom holsters. I think his name is Ray. And with anything custom, you guys know that comes with lead times and waiting periods. So I was quoted 7 to 8 weeks before I would get this holster. But I was pleasantly surprised because I received it within 6 weeks ahead of schedule. So I got it in the mail. I got it last week. So basically for the past week, I've been breaking in this holster. I've been wearing it around the house, testing and evaluating it and seeing how it functions within the confines of my own home. I have not used this or taken this out on the streets just yet, but I will be shortly. So in this video, I figured I'd just kind of share with you my thoughts on this holster, show it to you. And in my usual fashion, at the end of the video, show you what this holster looks like on my person and how it, functions, basically. But before I go on, I just wanted to quickly share with you a little story. Recently, I was at a public range, all right? I was basically shooting the pug nose, training with it, practicing with it. And I met this young kid. I call him young kid, but he's 26 years old. He had a VP9, and we got talking shop, guns and gears. And he was totally shocked that I was carrying a revolver. He's like, "Are you serious, man? What the hell?" Like, he was just totally baffled that I was carrying something like this as a primary. He was carrying a VP9 in some type of plastic holster. And he was going off on Kydex. And, he saw that I was using a Simply Rugged, which is a leather holster, inside the waistband. And he's like, "Oh, you can't be using that, man. Oh." He said something like, "Revolvers and leather, what are you, stuck in the 50s? I'm like, "What?" He's like, leather holsters and leather belts equates to cassette tapes, VHS, VCRs. It's a thing of the past, and that's old technology. You got to get with the times. I'm like, wow, okay, sure. And he was going off about, is this Kydex and SOC or no, what is it, SOE gear stuff, the belt he has, nylon belt. That's all fine and dandy, but, I like leather. If it works, it works. And if it starts to exhibit any type of failures, then you get rid of it and get another one. That's just how it goes. I mean, I like Kydex plastic holsters, but I've been a leather fan for many, many, many years. Up until more recently, I jumped on the bandwagon with Kydex holsters and stuff like that. But I like a good leather holster. But I just wanted to throw that in there because I thought it was kind of funny. These thought leather in a revolver is from the 50s. Wow. Alright, so let's get into this. This holster here, again, Lobo Gun Leather. The model is called Enhanced Pancake. And I chose this specific model because my primary goal is concealment. I want to carry outside the waistband with with the mindset of concealing this pug nose. So I liked what I saw on his website in regards to the Enhanced Pancake. The pictures intrigued me. His description intrigued me. So I picked the Enhanced Pancake. Options, hammer shield. I always like a hammer shield on my holsters, and it's made for a 1.5 inch belt, and specifically custom made for the 327 2 inch, which is right there. So let's check this thing out. Basically, it looks like this. Now, when I first took this out of the bag, I immediately thought of quality. I was like, wow, this thing is like really well made, and not only well made, this thing is tough as nails. I mean, it's not collapsing or anything. I mean, this is like almost like a Kydex holster, the way this thing is built. I don't know how he got it so tight and stiff. So this is what it looks like. Just give you some shots. The stitching, the molding, everything is pretty good on this thing. And as you can tell right away, the belt loops are behind the holster. Okay, they're not in front. So if we flip it around, you see how the belt would go through that channel right there and go through this channel. But let me just let you see this. Look how steep that angle is right there on this holster. So if you're going to use a double thick gun belt, you're going to have a little bit of an annoyance and problem looping that belt through this because of the steep angle right here. So you're going to put the belt through here, and then you got to kind of loop it through there, which is a very, very steep angle. So that could be an issue. So like this Zax leather gun belt, this is double thick. I have had a bit of an issue looping it through this. My old school Milt Sparks belt that I have owned since 2002, I think, it goes in there no problem. So it will go in there. The reason for this design is that if you know, a little bit behind the 3 o'clock position on your hip, this holster is just like right up against your body for ultimate concealment, and it works. So this design does work, but just to show you that angle there, it's pretty steep, just to put it out there. And the molding is really tight. It's like I said, it's almost like a Kydex holster, and you got that Lobo logo right there. I think it's a wolf, right? And it's pretty, I would say this is pretty good quality, guys. Look how thick that leather is. I think he must use, I think it was like a welted seam construction, he called it. Utilizes a third layer of leather sewn in between here. So, I mean, this thing is tough as nails. The molding is tight. So let's check out what the revolver looks like in this holster. And when I first got this, the gun would not go in this holster at all. I had to force it in. So it is broken in now. So watch, it just goes right in. It's still tight. Retention is ultra tight. But when I first got this, I had to force this revolver into this holster. But it's broken in now, so it works out very nicely. You know, I didn't do all the little tricks and little things like that to break it in faster, just because I was not in a hurry. So I just left the gun in the holster for a bunch of nights, and then it just naturally broke in. And I've been wearing it around the house, drawing from concealment and stuff like that. Works out great. As you can see how short this is and how compact this holster looks, all right? You know, like the Simply Rugged is huge. It's a pancake, so it's huge. This one here is just right. It's just got enough leather, you know, to cover the gun, and it rides high, short barrel. I can have a t-shirt and wear this thing, and it's concealed pretty damn good, for real, except for these grips. I am going to get rid of these grips. I just have to, because this is kind of hindering the concealment process. So these grips are going to go for some little bit of, just a little bit shorter. It's going to be perfect as a concealment. And if I could carry this outside the waistband versus inside the waistband, that's another A plus, because it's much, much, much more tolerable outside the waistband, almost comfortable. Being so lightweight, this is a great carry system right here. This holster, this specific revolver, the size of the revolver, the way this rides up on the belt pretty high up, it's pretty perfect, guys. So this holster really does work out. Just kind of showing it to you. And I'll show you what it looks like on my person. Now, I just want to throw this out there. When I was, you know, testing and evaluating this holster in the home, I was wearing basically some khaki pants, my Carhartt khaki pants. The black dye did come off and left a pretty large imprint that goes around here, like from here probably down here on my pants. So just to put that out there, that's just in, you know, the break-in phase. The dye just came off. You know, I put the pants in the wash and it came out, but just want to throw that out there. Don't freak out when you see black dye and outline on your pants, but I just want to throw that out there. So there you go, guys. Pretty nice holster. Get these grips shorter. This is going to be probably the ultimate concealment rig. I really like it. See that? All right. So let's get to it, and let me show you what it looks like on my person. All right, let's go. All right, now I have the holster on me. This Lobo Enhanced Pancake holster is right here, so I can let you guys take a look at it. As you can see, if I were to move like this a little bit, this grip kind of pushes out a little bit. So it juts out just a tiny bit, but that is why I need to change these grips out. Because if I try to conceal it, and I bend over or do anything like that, this pops out pretty badly. I was at the local Walmart, what have you, bending over. I mean, no one says anything, but you can definitely see it. So this is what it looks like. So let me give you a closer look at this holster on my person outside the waistband. It rides higher, short barrel right there, so it's pretty good. If we get shorter grips, just a little bit shorter, this will work out pretty well. But to draw, you know, basically from concealment, if I was like this, I would just basically pull it up like that. And the angle of this holster, okay, facilitates a pretty good draw. One-handed reholstering, not a problem. Goes right back in. So it works out pretty well. So just want to show you this. It is nicely broken in right now, and I really like it. Works out very well, guys. So you just check that out. If I want to go like this. So Alright guys, that's about it. I give it an A+. Stay tuned. I'll give you an update on how this holster works out in the next few months. So as always guys, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.